the dot product, level 2. In the previous video, we covered the geometric definition of the dot product. In this video, we will derive another method to compute the dot product between two vectors by using their components. We can calculate the scalar product A dot B directly if we know the x, y, and z components of vector A and vector B. To see how this is done, let's use a three-dimensional coordinate system to draw vector A and vector B, each having an x, y, and z component. Before we start deriving an expression to calculate the scalar product by using the components of vector A and vector B, we first need to determine the dot products of the unit vectors I, j, and k. This will be pretty easy since I, j, and k all have a magnitude equal to 1, and they are perpendicular to each other. Recall from the previous video that the dot product between two vectors can be found by taking the product of the magnitudes of each vector times cosine of the angle between the vectors. Let's use the geometric definition to find the dot product of all the possible combinations between the unit vectors, which include I hat dot I hat, j hat dot j hat, k hat dot k hat, I hat dot j hat, I hat dot k hat, and j hat dot k hat. The first three dot products involve vectors that are parallel to one another. In other words, the angles between them is 0 degrees. So to calculate the dot product, we simply multiply the magnitudes of the vectors. Doing that, we obtain the scalar 1. Now, for the next three dot products, the vectors are going to be orthogonal to one another. In other words, forming a right angle between the unit vectors. Recall that the dot product of orthogonal vectors is equal to 0, since cosine of 90 degrees is equal to 0. Alright, now that we have the results of these six dot products, let's proceed with finding the dot product of vector A and vector B. Let's go ahead and express vector A and vector B in unit vector form. Then, it is just a matter of expanding the product just the way you multiply polynomials with one another. Doing that, we obtain the following 9 terms. Next, let's rearrange the constants and unit vectors in each term as follows. Finally, we go ahead and compute the dot product of all the unit vectors. In this case, 6 of the 9 terms are going to be equal to 0, since the unit vectors are orthogonal to one another. And 3 of the 9 terms that survive give the final expression for the dot product of two vectors in terms of their components. From this expression, we see that the scalar product of two vectors is a sum of the product of the respective components. You can think about it as a sum of the products of the vector's parallel components. We now have two distinct ways to calculate the scalar product between two vectors. We can use the geometric interpretation, or if the components of both vectors are known, we find the dot product in terms of vector components. Notice that both the geometric definition and the component form produce a scalar, not a vector. This is consistent with the way the dot product is defined. Although we derived the vector component form of the dot product for three-dimensional vectors, the dot product of planar or two-dimensional vectors is defined in a similar fashion. In this case, you simply remove the third, or z, component. Alright, now let's talk about the properties of the dot product. Let u, v, and w be vectors in a plane, or in space, and let c be a scalar. Then, u dot v is equal to v dot u. This is known as the commutative property of the dot product. The proof of this and the other properties are mostly computational proofs. For example, to prove the commutative property, we first define vector u and vector v in component form. Then, by using the vector component definition of the dot product, we express u dot v as follows. Then, by using the commutative property of multiplication for real numbers, we rearrange the product This expression is essentially v.u, and this ends the proof. Okay, the next property is u dot the quantity of vector v plus vector w is equal to u dot v plus u dot w. This is essentially the distributive property for dot products. The proof of this property is very similar to the previous property. We first rewrite the vectors in component form as follows. This way, we can apply the various properties of real numbers to rewrite the expression. So we go ahead and apply the vector component definition of the dot product, obtaining the following expression. Then, we go ahead and distribute the x, y, and z components of vector u. Then, it is just a matter of grouping the corresponding terms together. The first grouping represents u dot v, and the second grouping represents u dot w. And this ends the proof. The third property is scalar c times the quantity u dot v is equal to scalar c times u dot v, which is also equal to u dot c times v. So essentially, we can multiply the constant to any vector and proceed with computing the dot product. The end result is that one of the vectors gets scaled by a factor of c. The fourth property was introduced in the previous video. This property states that the zero vector times any vector is equal to zero. Recall that the zero vector is orthogonal to every vector v. Finally, the last property is pretty interesting. It turns out that if you take the dot product of a vector with itself, you end up with an expression that represents the magnitude of the vector squared. As a proof, we simply compute the dot product of a vector with itself. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Notice that this expression is already canned in the formula for the magnitude of a vector. So this expression is essentially the square root of the x component squared plus the y component squared plus the z component squared, all raised to the power of 2. The expression in the parentheses represents the magnitude of the vector. If you think about it, from a geometric point of view, we are essentially multiplying the magnitude of vector v with itself. In addition, both vectors will be parallel, facing the same direction. The angle between the vectors is 0 degrees, and the dot product reduces to multiplication of the vector's magnitude with itself, or in this case, the magnitude squared. Alright, and these are the 5 properties of the dot product. In our next video, we will go over several examples illustrating how to solve problems that make use of the dot product definition.